This video provides an overview of the concepts and terminology of Globus Connect Server. Globus Connect Server is a multi-user deployment that connects your storage system with the Globus ecosystem. Users can then use it for reliable and secure data access and transfer and for collaborative data sharing. The deployment is typically done by an administrator and on servers managed by the institution. The servers, often called data transfer nodes, are set up on in-science DMZs. These are network systems that have been set up for high-performance data transfers. At least one data transfer node is required for a Globus Connect Server deployment. Multiple such nodes can be deployed for performance and capacity reasons. The Globus Connect software is installed on each of these data transfer nodes. And an endpoint is a logical construct in the Globus ecosystem that allows the administrator to manage and configure the servers. For example, network use is configured at the endpoint level. Globus supports a variety of storage types, from POSIX to object stores to tape archives. And the way that is done is using a connector. By default, a POSIX connector is installed on the data transfer nodes, and it can be used for accessing any mounted file system. A storage gateway provides an interface for policy and configuration of the storage system. An administrator creates a storage gateway. It is associated with a particular type of storage. So the examples here use POSIX. And they can use that interface to configure authentication, authorization, and data use policies. So the example here shows configuration that determines what domain a user needs to authenticate from to access data, authorization policies in terms of who is allowed to access the data, and the local accounts that are used are configured here. And the storage gateway can also be flagged for use with high assurance or protected data that adds additional capabilities in there. Storage gateways are interfaces only for administrators, and users do not use this interface. If an endpoint supports multiple storage types, additional connectors are added. In this example, an AWS S3 connector is added so that the endpoint can be used for accessing data on S3. A storage gateway is created associated with that particular storage type, and it can have its own policies. Finally, collections are the construct that support data access interfaces. Collections support both bulk data transfers. So using the Globus transfer service, you could do third-party transfers and reliable data transfers. Collections also support HTTPS access for upload and download of data. An administrator creates mapped collections. These are collections that allow users who have local accounts to access their data. Mapped collections are created on the storage gateway, and they inherit all of the policies and enforcement that has been set up at the storage gateways. If enabled by an administrator, users can create guest collections on these mapped collections for sharing data with their collaborator. These guest collections are created by users, and permissions can be set at a folder level to allow collaborators to access data via the guest collection. These collaborators do not need local accounts for accessing the data. Globus documentation site provides detailed instructions for how to set up a Globus Connect server, and the various configuration options that are provided to the admin are also documented as a part of the Globus Connect server guides.